superstar Dolph Ziggler.
AJ South.
Becky Lynch.
Josh. Seth freaking Rollins. This is Britta Live on YouTube.
What is going on, guys? Britta Live back with another video, and welcome to the Week in Review, episode 93. We're going to start off with Monday Night Raw. Monday Night Raw wasn't really too much of an improvement from last week. But yeah, this is where we talk about Raw and SmackDown in a setup style. I'll tell you guys what happened. I tell you guys what I thought about the moment or certain match. So without further ado, let's jump into Monday Night Raw. Starting over here, it was an episode of The Dirt Sheet with Miz and Morrison with special guests, supposedly Goldberg and Drew McIntyre. But in the end, we eventually got Goldberg and some random dude playing Drew McIntyre horrendously. But yeah, it was pretty cool seeing Goldberg again. The guy playing Drew McIntyre, oh my god. But yeah, this was it wasn't really the biggest fan of this promo. I just thought, oh man, I'm way too old to be watching this. I don't know if I'm the only one that got that vibe from this, but I'm like, I'm way too old to be watching this. This is bad. Like, what the heck is going on? But yeah, I wasn't really the biggest fan of that promo at all. But then they said next week the real Drew McIntyre and the real Goldberg are gonna go face to face. So I'm excited for that. Moving over here, no, it wasn't Mustafa Ali versus Xavier Woods. It was actually Mace this week. Last week it was T-Bar, but this week it was Mace going up against Xavier Woods for whatever reason. I thought Retribution was going after Ricochet, and they're like, this doesn't stop until you join Retribution. So I guess it stopped and they lied. And now they're going after Xavier Woods for whatever reason. I feel like the entire group is just lost. And like, they're just lost in WWE. They're just lost. But yeah, in the end, Mace ended up beating Xavier Woods, and then it was, I don't care. It's like, literally, I have no interest at all in Retribution. No interest at all. They're not entertaining, and I know they're supposed to be heels, but I just don't find them entertaining at all. They're not fun to watch at all. Moving over here, it was AJ Styles versus Ricochet, and I was looking forward to this match. The match itself was okay, but when we're talking about the finish of the match, I'm like, whoa, this is cool. Okay, so AJ had him up, threw him, he like had him up in like a suplex position, and he dropped him on the top rope. Ricochets, pun intended, off the top rope and then lands onto AJ Styles in the Styles Clash position, and then boom, drops him with a Styles Clash. I'm like, that is a sick Styles Clash. I really wanted to see how Ricochet picked up the victory. I don't think it would have hurt to give Ricochet this victory. But yeah, honestly, AJ Styles is getting ruined by Omos on the ringside. I feel like he doesn't need Omos at all, and almost is actually ruining the character of AJ Styles. Honestly, I feel like he's ruining AJ Styles. And Ricochet honestly should have got this victory. It wouldn't have made AJ Styles look bad, trust me. And in the end, I liked the finish, but the match sucked itself, in my opinion. In my opinion. Moving over here, it was Charlotte versus Peyton Royce. This was actually the opening match. And it was okay. Honestly, I feel like they were just wasting time. They were just throwing each other around, not really doing the craziest of maneuvers. It was just lame, man. All the way up until Lacey Evans and Ric Flair ended up coming out, and Lacey Evans was wearing one of Ric Flair's robes, I guess, just to try to distract Charlotte. It didn't work this week. Peyton Royce went for the roll-up, and then after, like, they did a couple more moves to each other, Charlotte actually locked in the figure eight and then beat Peyton Royce by tap out, so that wasn't bad. But then again, it's just boring. Like, I don't care. Like, I don't know. I don't know if I'm the only one that feels this way about Raw nowadays. It's just like, I don't care, dude. All right, so we got the Hurt Business, Cedric Alexander, Shelton Benjamin, and Bobby Lashley versus the Lucha House Party and Matt Riddle. I feel like we've seen this match plenty of times already, but I guess we're seeing it again here. It was pretty interesting, I gotta admit. It was pretty interesting watching the Hurt Business have a little controversy in the corner with tagging in and all this. I'm like, ooh, this is pretty interesting. I did enjoy that part. But then the end, I feel like we've seen this ending a billion times. Bobby Lashley locks in the Hurt Business and it's over. I'm like, what? Like, what? So yeah, he taps out Grandma Malik, but then after the match, Matt Riddle goes in for another cheap shot and just hightails, gets out of the ring. And I'm like, okay, so that happened already. Like, can I see something different? Please. But yeah, I gotta admit, it was pretty cool seeing her business have some controversy. Moving over here with Shayna Baszler versus Mandy Rose in a 1-on-1 match. This is another match that I feel like we've seen for the insane amount of times. It's either Shayna versus Dana or Shayna versus Mandy. I swear, it's like literally every week. I don't know if I feel the same way. Again, let me know in the comments down below if I'm way too hard on these Monday Night Raws. But yeah, Shayna Baszler, Mandy Rose. In the end, Shayna Baszler just tapped her out. And then after the match, Well, she tapped her out with the Carafeed clutch, but then after the match, Shayna and Nia were on ringside having a little miscommunication after the match, too, which was odd. And then Dana Brooke just dropkicked both of them and left them on the mat, and then they left. I'm like, okay, whatever. That was pretty boring. Moving over here, Before It Falls, we had Jeff Hardy. Look at that, dude. He's on the top rope. Literally no glue, nothing. He's just on the top rope right there, no string. But yeah, it was Jeff Hardy versus Jackson Ryker again this week. And yeah, this was like the weirdest ending. So okay, Elias was on ringside, of course. He was about to hit the Swanton Bomb. Here comes Elias, pushes Jeff off the top rope. Ding, 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 ding. Disqualification. And of course they're trying to do because Jackson Ryker, who I'm intending to be this guy, said... don't get involved. But then he was like, hey, why'd you get involved? I told you not to. And then Elias was like, I thought you were being sarcastic. So I'm like, okay, whatever. But yeah, Jeff Hardy should have won clean, honestly. Even though he did by disqualification, but he should have won clean, honestly. Jeff Hardy deserves way more. Opening, I guess you could say promo of the show, we had Randy Orton backstage addressing his injuries, which was cool. I gotta say, this was a cool way to open up the show. He had like a fire burn mask on. It reminded me of Juan Cena, if anybody remembers Juan Cena. But yeah, I thought this was pretty cool. It was him backstage basically talking about how all he sees is the fire hitting his eyes when he opens his eyes, and the voices in his head are louder than they've ever been. So that was pretty interesting. And it was pretty cool seeing him with that fire mask on. I'm like, this is sick. I like this. And then he was like, oh man, I hate how I showed sympathy for Alexa Bliss when I tried to set her on fire. I'm like, ooh, interesting. But what I thought was very interesting about this, he was talking about how his entire face got first-degree burns, but his eyelashes and eyebrows are still there. So I'm like, whoa. I knew Jeff Hardy was going to fall. But I was like, wait. I thought his face got first-degree burns. Why are his eyelashes and eyebrows still there? But yeah, it was still cool. There's no denying that. It was still really cool. I did enjoy it. Moving over here, it was the main event of the show. It was actually Alexa Bliss versus Asuka in a one-on-one match. I don't really like the new Alexa. Well, first, it was Alexa's playground, and she just scared Asuka away. And then it was a main event later in the show. And then Asuka lost, shockingly. I gotta say, Asuka lost. Very shockingly. And then Alexa Bliss just hit the Sister Abigail, boom, 1, 2, 3. And then yeah, it's like she changed attires mid-match when they came back from commercial. She had like black lipstick on, like fully different attire. But then after the end of the match, then she was back in her original attire. I was like, this is just weird, man. I don't like the new Alexa Bliss, honestly. But yeah, she beat Asuka, and then she declared herself into the Royal Rumble entry. So she could win the Royal Rumble, you never know. But yeah, guys, that was Monday Night Raw in a nutshell. In the end, I'm going to give it a 5 out of 10. I thought this was a weak show. Some minor good parts, but I can't give it over a 5, dude. Just being honest, I thought I was really bored most of the time. But yeah, guys, now we're gonna jump into SmackDown. Moving into SmackDown, it wasn't a half bad show whatsoever. We are gonna jump right into it. Starting over here, it was Baron Corbin, not versus Rey Mysterio, but versus Dominic Mysterio. Before this match, it showed Dominic and Rey Mysterio backstage. Dominic's like, don't worry, Rey, I got this tonight, I got this. And Rey's like, if you lose, next time, you're taking my advice. And then Dominic's like, don't worry, I got this. And turned out, Dominic doesn't have it. He went out to the ring, and he ended up losing to King Corbin with an end of days. So, turns out next time, I guess Rey Mysterio is gonna have to put some advice on Dominic, and Dominic better take the advice, because, you know, that's what he promised his dad. So definitely. But yeah, again, Baron Corbin did beat him. It was okay. Not my favorite match of the night at all. But yeah, it was just okay. Moving over here, it was Sasha Banks versus the Sommelier Reginald of Carmella. This was pretty interesting. Reginald, I gotta say, hats off to you, man. This was actually pretty freaking good. He had a pretty good showing against Sasha Banks. It was a woman versus men match. I thought it was pretty interesting. Thought it was pretty cool. And yeah, there was some pretty cool high-flying maneuvers and like acrobatics that one dude Reginald did. I thought that was pretty cool. But in the end, Sasha Banks ended up tapping him out with the bank statement, just hyping up a little more. Of course, I honestly think we're gonna see Carmella versus Sasha Banks again for the SmackDown Women's Championship, which I'm totally fine with. Their first match wasn't that bad, but yeah, pretty good build up right there. Moving over here, this was the obstacle course between Bianca Belair and Bayley. This was very interesting. So first, Bayley's like, okay, I want to go first. And then she had the obstacle course set up to her ability, and then she ran through it. I'm like, okay, you know, I think she got like a minute and 23. Don't quote me on that. And then she's like, Bianca Belair, you're up. And then like, she's like, hey, change up the course. And then they like change everything to like super harder positions, and it's harder for Bianca Belair. And first they had to do a fireman's carry, so Bayley had to do it to Shorty G. But then Bianca Belair had to do it to Otis, the near 300 plus pounder, and she was able to do it and still beat the time. But then after, Bayley got super jealous and then took her out. And I'm like, oh my gosh, are you serious? Pretty obvious. I saw it coming. But yeah, this was definitely pretty entertaining. I enjoyed it. Moving over here, it was Asuka and Charlotte versus Ruby Riott and Liv Morgan. I honestly cannot stand any of this Riot Squad crap. It is literally garbage. And this Asuka and Charlotte stuff, it's just so boring. But yeah, they had a tag team match anyways. And of course, Billy Kay trying to get with the Riot Squad failed again and made him lose again. So, and then in the end, Charlotte just hit the natural selection, 1-2-3, and beat him. It was boring, and I honestly couldn't care less about Billy Kay. And then later backstage, they're like, Billy Kay, it's better with just me and Liv Morgan and Ruby Riott. I'm like, whatever, it doesn't, I don't even care. Moving over here, this was pretty interesting. So Daniel Bryan's out there, he's like, I'm gonna win the Royal Rumble for the first time. This is gonna be awesome. And then Cesaro interrupts him like, ooh, Cesaro, I like Cesaro. We didn't see Shinsuke Nakamura, which was a little odd, in this show. We didn't see a couple other people, which I will mention. Well, right now, Robert Roode wasn't there. I'm like, what? Where's Robert Roode? What the heck? I feel like legit. Dolph Ziggler is a SmackDown, you know, SmackDown Tag Team Champion, and so is Robert Roode. You'd think he'd be out there. I don't know what's going on with Robert Roode. I don't know if there's like an injury that I don't know about or something, but yeah, he wasn't there. But in the end, Cesaro had a pretty good match against Ziggler and then hit the Gotch Neutralizer to pick up the victory. Pretty cool match, honestly. I'm really liking the new Cesaro, and I also am really liking the new Shinsuke as a face. It's pretty interesting seeing Cesaro as a heel, Shinsuke as a face, and they're sort of still a tag team, but not really. It's pretty cool. Moving over here, it was Big E versus Apollo Crews for the Intercontinental Championship. I gotta be completely honest with you guys, my TV did cut out and randomly disconnect to the Wi-Fi for whatever reason, so I missed the end of this match. But I looked on Instagram, and it turns out that Sami Zayn actually rushed the ring and then made it a disqualification. So still, your Intercontinental Champion, Big E. Honestly, I couldn't really care less for this. Honestly, I would have loved to seen actually a really good match between these two. But then, of course, Sami Zayn had to interfere. He was like on ringside, handcuffing himself to the barricade and saying like, "There's the conspiracy and all this crap." I'm like, "Oh my gosh, Sami Zayn, come on!" But yeah, not bad, I guess. Moving over here, end of the show. It was Paul Heyman versus Adam Pearce in a one-on-one match, and turnabout is fair play. Paul Heyman was like, "Oh, I think I just sustained an injury." Card subject to change, and then Roman Reigns comes out. So it's Roman Reigns versus Adam Pearce. He starts beating the crap out of him, bringing up to the entrance stage with the destroyed Kevin Owens. And then in the end, Kevin Owens got him down by the announcer's table, sent him through the announcer's table with the steel. He sent him through the announcer's table with the pop-up powerbomb, and then he tried to use the steel stairs, and the WWE officials were holding him back. I'm like, what the heck? Why do they never hold back Roman Reigns? But they hold back Kevin Owens. Like, what the heck? Like, that's so stupid. I know it's fake, but still, that doesn't make any sense. Why are you holding back Kevin Owens, but you're not holding back Roman Reigns when he's beating the crap out of Kevin Owens? Doesn't make any sense to me. Maybe Roman's more aggressive. I don't know. But still, honestly, that was a little weird. And also, another thing that was really weird, Jey Uso wasn't there. When Kevin was getting the upper hand, I'm like, where's Jey? Where's Jey? Where's Jey? He's going to come out. Where's Jey? Nope. No Jay. I'm like, what? What's going on here? It's interesting. But it was pretty cool to see Kevin Owens on top and finally beating the crap out of Roman Reigns instead of vice versa, Roman beating Kevin Owens up. But yeah, guys, that was SmackDown. That was Raw setup style. In the end, I'm going to give SmackDown a solid 7 out of 10. I thought some stuff was pretty weak. Yes, that did fall. Sorry about that. Got a little too close to it with the camera. But yeah, guys, that was Raw and SmackDown setup style. Really enjoyed. Bread Alive. Out.